Hello everyone, thanks for tuning in to this evening's video, doing the April Muppet forecast for this evening. We'll have a quick review of the March forecast. At the end, we'll have a sneak peek very quickly at May. So the March forecast was actually for average temperatures, average precipitation, but before it probably get colder and warmer spells offsetting one another. And rainfall, again, very much offsetting one another. So quite unsettled periods. Being offset by drier periods as well. And averaging it all out, we thought we would come out close to average with the temperatures. We'll have a look and see how we did in a second. But very good on all of that, just say about the ads. There's links to articles on all the pages. Have a browse through widgets and click through the links. If there's any articles that you're interested in, thanks very much for doing that. There's video ads on most pages. They open up the content, you watch them, they'll close back up again. It helps to pay for gazwebbies.com. So just starting off with central England temperature, see how the temperature forecast did. So this is the final number from Hadley for March 2016. We came out at 5.8, which is an anomaly of just 0.1 of a degree above average. So more or less bang on average for the 61 to 1990 average anyway. If we was looking at a more modern average, say 81 to 2010, it would actually be a bit colder than average this month. So, well, the forecast was close to average temperatures. I think we overall did come out close to average, but we probably erred on the side of being colder, if anything, particularly when you compare it to a more modern average. So I suppose the forecast, and in terms of temperatures, wasn't too bad. I would say probably was actually a little bit cooler than average for the UK overall, particularly compared to a more modern average temperature. In terms of the precipitation, we did have quite a wet start, and then it turned wetter towards the end with a drier period in the middle. So that came out fairly reasonably well also. So overall, I don't think we've done too bad with the March forecast. It was a fairly changeable month. We did get unsettled periods and colder periods. We did get drier periods as well. So pretty changeable and near normal with the temperatures, near normal with the precipitation. I don't think we did too badly with the March 2016 forecast. So let's go on and have a look at how April is shaping up. We can start off CFS V2 700 millibar anomaly for the month. So this is how it's looking in April. We've got a deep trough of low pressure still in the Atlantic. This has been an omnipresent feature throughout the past few months, of course. And then we've got this ridge well away from us in the central part of the Atlantic, and also ridging up to the north. It means it's a fairly changeable month being signalled here with the jet stream coming through the country. You would expect quite an unsettled, fairly Atlantic-driven April. And there's no sign of anything particularly warm here either, I don't think, because the orientation of this ridge out in the middle of the Atlantic and then the trough in the northern Atlantic means the jet stream is probably a bit to the south. We're probably aligning the flow northwest to southeast. So overall, I don't think we're looking at anything particularly warm. We aren't placing that high pressure to the south or to the east, particularly to draw up extended southerly influences. Let's have a look at the temperature anomaly, and that's coming out close to average. Notice most of Europe, central, eastern, northeastern Europe, actually coming out quite warm. But for the west of Europe, UK, Ireland, France, Spain, Portugal, it does look cooler. And I think that's probably reasonable with the temperature, with the height anomaly forecast. I think the temperature signal probably is close to average, maybe even a bit on the cool side, if anything. The precipitation anomalies from CFS V2 for the coming month indicates quite wet conditions, actually. Most of Western Europe coming out generally wetter than average. So an Atlantic-driven, cool, unsettled month looks likely from the CFS V2. It's not a mild Atlantic-driven pattern such as we had back in the winter. It's generally a cooler, probably polar maritime type Atlantic influence pattern. Let's have a look at the Beijing Climate Centre. That's CFS V2. We're going to have a look at the BCC next. And these are 500 millibar high anomalies broken down into 10-day periods. So the first 10-day period takes us from the 1st of the 10th. We'll look at the 11th 20th, and then, of course, the final 10-day period of May 21st through to the 30th. So for the coming 10-day period, we're placing, again, a ridge up to the northeast and in the central part of the Atlantic, and then we've got this trough to the northwest and cut off down to the south. So this means that the flow is going rather like that. So again, it does place us on the cool side of the jet stream, and it has us in sort of a northwest-southeast pattern between those two ridges. So quite unsettled, quite cool for the first 10 days of April. We go into the middle 10 days, this is the 11th through to the 20th, and again, the trough of low pressure is up to the north, the ridge is through central part of the Atlantic. So once again, I think it's all aligning a bit like that. It means the jet stream's coming through the country, so quite a changeable month. Also lined up on a northwest-southeast trajectory, so it's likely to be fairly cool as well. No signal for anything especially warm. And then we go through to the last 10 days of the month, and this is really quite poor, actually. This is from the 21st through to the 30th of April. That trough, if anything, is sinking down across the country, so it's more or less centred over the UK. The ridge, again, is through the central part of the Atlantic, the above average area of heights. And again, the jet stream is lining up like that, northwest to southeast, generally going a bit to the south of the country within that trough in the 500 millibar flow. So once again, it's likely to be fairly changeable and fairly cool there going into the final 10 days of April. This looks like a very mixed and rather cool month. So the temperature anomaly is coming out colder than average with the Beijing Climate Centre across the west of Europe and through central parts of Europe as well. And then the precipitation anomaly, you'll not be surprised with such an unsettled month being predicted, that's coming out generally above average. So a cool wet month, or cool unsettled month anyway, looks likely for April. So we've got agreement here between these two models, the CFS-V2 and Beijing Climate Centre. Both want to have us in Atlantic-driven month, so it's an unsettled month, both going for above-average rainfall. They differ a little bit with temperatures, the CFS more towards average temperatures, Beijing Climate Centre very clearly going for a colder than average month, with the jet stream aligned northwest to southeast. And a trough in the 500 millibar flow. It's not great pattern for the middle month of the spring. Now, do we think this is believable? Well, I think this could well be the way things pan out. Of course, we can expect different differences as the month develops compared to what these charts are showing in terms of the 500 millibar height, particularly the Beijing Climate Centre, which is broken down into 10-day periods. But I think overall, an Atlantic-driven, unsettled, and fairly cool month looks like. We've got the cold pool in the Atlantic, as we know, cold sea surface temperature anomaly. So if that jet stream lines up northwest to southeast, as opposed to what we have through the winter, which was southwest to northeast and dragged up a lot of mild air out of the Azores and the tropics, I don't think we'll get that all that often this April. So I expect we'll line things up southwest, northwest to southeast, and that's likely to be fairly cool. So it's always dangerous in this country at the moment predicting a colder than average month. We haven't had one since September, and we know through the winter, particularly the early winter, really was very, very, very exceptionally mild. But I'm going to risk it and go for a colder than average month this April, which means a bit of a delayed spring. I don't think it'll be anything too dramatic. Don't be expecting blizzards covering the country, anything like that. I don't think there'll be much there for the Express to get too excited about. But I do think we'll probably come out a bit colder than average, which could allow for some wintry conditions, especially over high ground in the north. And I would also expect that we're likely to see some night frost as well. That could be more prominent, actually, than snow. I think there will be night frost on and off, particularly in the first bit of the month, which delays the onset of spring a bit. So a cooler than average month is the prediction from GavsOfThis.com for April, probably by around half a degree, something like that. Nothing too dramatically cold. It'll be our first cooler than average month since September if it comes off, And, of course, it'll be first call of an average April since 2013. So, it'll be quite a noteworthy month this one. In terms of precipitation, I haven't spoken about. But, of course, the precipitation forecast is above average. I think we have quite a wet month, especially again in the first half of the month. It may all become a bit drier and warmer in the second half. Finally, having a very quick sneak peek at May. This is how the CFSB2 is shaping up for May, and on the face of it, it's not great. Again, really, the trough of low pressure is centred over the country. The ridge is a bit closer to us. It's heading in towards Spain, so if anything, it could line things up a bit more like that, perhaps drag some warmer air up from the south and the southwest. But overall, still a pretty mixed signal, really, for May. Not a tremendous amount to go on there in terms of it turning significantly warmer or drier. We'll worry about May when we get to it. Finally, having a quick sum up of April. So we're looking at our first call of an average month since September, we think, and probably the first call of an average April since April 2013. Rainfall likely to be above average. Expect the chance of some wintry conditions, especially over high ground in the north, and that's in terms of sleet and snow. In terms of frost, that could be more of a problem, with the chance of some frosty nights through the month, which will probably delay the onset of spring. As ever, we will evaluate when we get through to next month, when we get through to May month forecast. So we'll see how we did. But that's all for now. Thanks for watching.